Hi there. I didn't see you come in.
My name is Max Devereaux, and today we're going to be making chocolate-covered pretzels. A relatively simple snack to create, sure, but ultimately a tasty treat to enjoy. Come with me.
Alright, the first thing that you're going to need to do before you start making your chocolate-covered pretzels is you're going to need to get your workspace cleared and ready to go.
As you can see, I've cleared off a workspace that's large enough for me to put all my necessary materials and all the things I'm going to be doing onto it.
Alright, here's the next part. You're going to have to get together all the things that you're going to need to build your pretzels.
Now the amount of these materials that you're going to need varies depending on how many chocolate-covered pretzels you're going to make. Begin by filling a small pot with water. Next, put your pot on the stove. Now set the heat setting to a high setting. Now set your other pot on top. This has created a fondue.
Now that you began your fondue, you can start adding the chocolate.
Take your chocolate morsels and put them into the pot. Now what you're going to do is you're going to use your spatula to stir your chocolate around.
It's going to begin melting soon. You got to make sure that it doesn't burn, because it will burn very easily.
I'm sensing my chocolate starting to melt, so now I'm just going to keep on stirring and make sure that it's not getting stuck. Now chocolate is a lot of fun, because you can do a lot with chocolate. Chocolate doesn't have to be one thing. It can be used in a variety of things. I've used it on pancakes, on bananas, on worms, wizards. So a variety of things. I mean, really, chocolate can be used on anything. I don't know what else you would use it on besides stuff like that. It's a great thing. Now we can really hear the fondue going. We know our chocolate's melting real nice here. We're going to set the heat setting a little lower. And just going to keep that melting. Lower heating. Set it to lower. Alright, now we're going to set it to lower heat. Just sort of mix it still. And it's really, oh man, that looks good. Wow. I don't know what to say. This is looking good. Really good. So, I think it's about done. So we're just going to turn off the heat here so we don't burn anything. We're just going to let it kind of cool. Not too much, though. I don't want it to just harden up again, because that's what it will do. And we're going to just keep mixing it, get all the sides, get everything off of here. Really looking good. I'm enjoying this a lot. Oh, man, look at that color. Look at that. Look at this. Mmm, that's good. It's good stuff. I think I chose the right chocolate. Wow, okay. The next thing you're going to be doing is taking your cookie sheet and placing your parchment paper onto it. Not really sure where the Here's our parchment paper. This looks good. So now we have our parchment paper set out. This is so that our chocolatey pretzels don't stick to the pan. Alright, here comes the fun part. We're gonna lay out our pretzel sticks. So I'm just gonna make a couple. Now we're gonna take our pot filled with our chocolate. Looking good. Looking real hot. Real good, real hot. Just getting all the chocolate off the sides here. And then we're just gonna take this and we're gonna drizzle it on these. Just drizzling our chocolate onto them. What is that? And we're just drizzling our chocolate. I'm sure there's a better way to do this, but this is the way that I'm doing it right now, which is good. So now we're gonna just continue to drizzle our chocolate onto the sticks to get them. Okay. So we have our chocolate drizzled on to the sticks, and we're just going to continue to make our chocolate covered pretzels. So now what we're going to do is we're going to just roll our sticks like so in the chocolate. What do we got here? It's really messy, but it's working. Sort of. Now if you'd like, you can take your sprinkles and just do some sprinkles on there. Just to really make it more interesting. I really like sprinkles. I really like sprinkles. Okay, so now we've got our finished product, but we're not done yet because these are still really hot. So now we're gonna set them in the fridge and just, right there. Oh, dear God. So that'll do it. So now we have some time to kill, so I think I'm going to dance. Cooled pretty well. So here's your final product. Bon appetit!